Have you considered buying your dream Colorado mountain home? Well, you're in the right place because I'm going to tell you 10 things that you need to know before making your move. Number one, and probably the biggest thing to consider, is inclement weather. Now, I know you're probably thinking, well, yeah, if I move to the mountains, obviously it's going to snow, but there are a lot of other weather patterns to consider other than just snow and ice before you move to the mountains. Colorado mountain towns can have issues with high wind, dense fog, flooding, and other weather patterns outside of snow and ice that you might not have considered. Things like high wind can cause a lot of issues for you as a property owner because it can down power lines, knock down trees, causing potential damage and hazards on your property. Not to mention, high wind can be a huge danger for an area that's already prone to fire hazards. Which brings me to point number two, fire danger. There is so much to consider when it comes to fire danger on a mountain property. Beyond just being aware that you might live in an area now where there's a higher risk for fire potential, there are a lot of things that you might need to do in order to adapt to living in a place where the fire danger is higher. This might include things like storing your valuables off-site so you wouldn't lose them in a potential home fire, as well as knowing all of your exit routes, your community resources, where you might exit your pets and livestock, and other valuable items that you may have at your property. Often in mountain communities, the fire department will have resources for homeowners in the area so that they can become more knowledgeable about exit routes and what they need to do in order to better assist for evacuation in case of a fire. Number three is your vehicle maintenance and what kind of vehicle you might need to drive. If you end up living in a mountain community, you may be able to get away with a vehicle that has less capabilities because the roads might be better plowed to and from your community. However, if you choose to live outside of a mountain community, you may be living off a road that isn't plowed by the county or the state, and therefore you may need a vehicle with better capabilities such as four-wheel drive, you may need studded tires, snow chains, or to carry sand in your vehicle with you. It can be more costly to own and maintain a four-wheel drive vehicle, and driving on mountain roads, even in the summertime, will significantly decrease the tires, and studded tires can cost a pretty penny. Number four, your home's utilities. If you choose to live in an established mountain community, you may have access to public sewer and water, as well as faster internet. Should you choose to live away from a mountain community, you may be as far as utilities are concerned, and therefore you may have to end up being on a well for your water, on a septic system instead of having a sewer line, and you may be on satellite internet, which can tend to have slower speeds. You might also have very limited cell phone service. You may also find yourself in an area where electricity power outages are common, especially in inclement weather, and you may need a secondary resource for electricity, such as a generator. And number five, access to amenities. Many mountain towns may have a small grocery store, a town doctor, and a few shops in town. However, if you choose to live outside of one of these mountain communities, you may need to consider your commute to things like the grocery store, your doctor, school, the gym, and any other amenities that you enjoy on a regular basis. You may also consider how far away you might be from restaurants if you're somebody who enjoys dining out, and there's probably not a lot of DoorDash in some of these mountain neighborhoods. Number six, your commute. Now I know you might be thinking, well, yeah, if I move further away, my commute's going to be longer. But just the distance isn't the only thing I want you to consider. Many mountain properties, especially those tucked away on their own acreage, usually have one or maybe two access roads in and out. Therefore, if something happens on one of these roads, like construction, an accident, or inclement weather makes it impassable, consider that an alternative route may potentially double your commute time. Not only is it critical to know these alternative routes, but it's also important to know how much longer they may put you away from where you're trying to go. Number 7, emergency services. If you are living far away from a community, your response time from emergency services could be significantly delayed, especially compared to those of a bigger city or a more suburban area. This could include delayed response times from services like police, fire, or medical. These are all things to consider and investigate before potentially purchasing your mountain property. Number 8, the life of your pets. Of course, your dog would love to run on several mountain acres. They'd be the happiest dog you know, right? However, something to consider is the fact that there is also wildlife already living in those areas that may not love your dog as much as you do. Or if you have other animals such as livestock, you may need to consider how they will fare in that environment, as well as what you might need to do to evacuate them in case of a fire. And number 9, wildlife. While you may be purchasing and moving into your new mountain home, consider the fact that the wildlife is already there in their home. And not only is there the obvious that wildlife like bears, mountain lions, or moose could potentially pose a threat to you physically, but you may also reconsider leaving your leftovers in your vehicle or food stored anywhere where they may try to get in and get access to it and damage your property. And number 10, my last and final point, property insurance. Mountain properties can oftentimes be more difficult and more expensive to insure due to the list of reasons that we just discussed. These homes may be at a higher risk for damage due to things like inclement weather, fire, wind, or other natural disasters. So what do you think? After considering all of those things, is the beauty of these gorgeous Colorado Rocky Mountains worth it to change the way you're living and move on up there and start your mountain life? Let me know what you think in the comments.